Hello everyone. So today in this video, let us see working with Servlet using Eclipse. I am Professor Dattatray Gandhmal from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Till now we have seen how to write a Servlet program. Now here we let us see how to write a Servlet program in Eclipse. That is what you will be able to understand after this video. So what is the learning outcome of this video? At the end of this session, students will be able to demonstrate environment settings to run Servlet program in Eclipse. So students has to do some kind of settings so that Servlet program will execute in Eclipse. Write a Servlet program using Eclipse IDE. So once you do these settings, you will be able to write a Servlet program and run Servlet program in Eclipse IDE. There are some settings, don't need to worry about it. I will tell you step by step. So working with it will be very easy. Okay, let us go. Now let's try a simple Servlet program in Eclipse step by step. Now first of all, you have to run an Eclipse IDE. I'm using your Eclipse Photon. Then come down to File, click New, go to Dynamic Web Project. So here we have Dynamic Web Project. In Dynamic Web Project, type the project name. I'll give the project name as test151, just a random number, test151. Okay, after that click Next, then a source folder will be visible, then click Next. After that, here you click Generate web.xml deployment descriptor. We have already seen what is web.xml file, right? Then click Finish. So once you do this, a test151 folder will be created, a project will be created, right? Then in this particular project, there are various folders. We have seen the folder structure, right? In folder structure, just see one by one, Java resources. What is there in Java resources? Their folder is empty right now. After that, we have web content. In web content, we have an important folder called as meta-inf. In meta-inf, click meta-inf. Here we have a file called as web.xml. We have already studied what is web.xml, right? And lib folder. So all your resources will lie here in web.inf folder, right? In source folder, you will create your own servlet file, okay? So how to create a servlet file? Now click on project, this particular source file, new. I'll select a file called as servlet, okay? So this window will come. Here you have to type your servlet name. What will be my class name? I'll give it as demo servlet, which we have given in the previous video. Same file name I'm using. Then click Next. Here there is a URL mapping, /demo servlet. Remember this. This URL mapping we have done in web.xml file in the previous video. Now we are in Eclipse. It gives me this dynamically. No need to do it. This comes automatically and I can use this /demo servlet. You can change it whatever you want. Okay, I'll keep it same. Click Finish. Now a file gets created. Right, so here we have a method called as doGet. What is this doGet? It is having two parameters, request and response. We have already studied this, right? This is an auto-generated code by Eclipse. I'll remove this, no need of it. We'll write our own code. Okay, now before that, you can see that there are some errors, HTTP servlet error and HTTP response error. Why these errors are coming? Yes, because servlet API file is not present, okay? Now, when I go to, so to remove this, come down to project folder again. So here, you click on build path, select build path, configure build path, then go to external jar files, add an external jar file. Now in external jar file, you will go to the location XAMPP, where XAMPP was installed in C drive. In C drive, you'll go to folder Tomcat. Right, in Tomcat I'll go to lib. In lib we have a file called as servlet api. I'll select this file, open it. Now servlet api.jar file is visible over here, okay? Then apply servlet api will be applied and it will be added as an external library file. Then apply and close. Now here you can see those all errors are vanished, right? So this is how we will import that particular jar file. Okay, in normal without Eclipse, we have already seen that we copy pasted a Servlet API file and put it there, right? But here, what we will do is we have done it this way. We have a UI and we have added it through UI. Now here, I need to write a code, doGet. What is the code? Response.setContent. Okay, response spelling is wrong. Response.setContentType. SetContent. Just a minute. SetContentType. Response.setContentType. Right? So I'll select this. Here, I'll mention the type of file. Okay, I'll give here it as text/HTML. Okay, text/HTML, because I'm going to write servlet program in HTML inside Java. So your HTML code is embedded inside Java file. This is what servlet is. We have studied in the previous video, right? Same thing we are doing in Eclipse. Now here, I need to have a print writer. I need to create its object, print writer PW equal to, this is its object, equal to response.getWriter. Get right. Okay. Now here it is showing error at print writer. Why? Because this import file is not there. I click on this particular icon, it will tell you the suggestion. So it's just select import, it will get added. Okay. After that, PW dot you select on, you have to print it, right? So PW dot print. Here you will write it as now what you will write here, HTML file, right? So I'll write it in one line, no need to write in multiple files. So it will be HTML file, then body of HTML, just an HTML code, you have to write it here. So I'll write it fast, H1. So this is the three tags. I'll write here, hello servlet. Okay, hello servlet is there. After that, /H1, you have to close all this, /body, then /HTML. So done with it. I think it is fine now. HTML body, H1, hello servlet, H1 body, servlet. Okay, it is fine. Now, save this particular thing. If I try to run it, it won't run because a server is not there. To add a server, I'll go to server tab. On server tab, click new, go to server, and here inside Apache, you take Tomcat 7.0 because I've installed 7.0 server. So I'll take this. Click next. So already this is there. Finish. So now Tomcat is started. Okay. Then once this is done, I will go to test 151, click on new, click on run as and run on server. Now here you can see Tomcat 7.0 server at localhost. Okay. Take this and finish. Now server has started and it is installed. You can see this. Now HTTP localhost 8080 test 151. Now it is not able to locate it. So we have given one mapping. I told you previously. What is that mapping? Demo servlet. Okay, if I put it, hello servlet. This is what our program is. Understood? It is very easy. Now you look at this folder configuration, webinf, web.xml file. Okay, this web.xml file, if you open, this is what web.xml file is. So all mapping kind of thing that demo servlet is done here. Okay, now we'll come back to Arun PPT. Let's try to answer this. Which basic library is required to be added for servlet program? So which API you are using? Pause here and try to answer this. servlet api.jar. How you have added this servlet api.jar? Here, test, right click, build path, configure build path. Here you have added servlet api.jar file. Now, if you want any more changes, you will come down to source file and here I can change. If I want it in multiple lines, how I'll write it in multiple lines? pw.print, and I will distribute this particular code in multiple lines. So I'll put it here only body. Okay, I'll close it here. Then I'll take this particular till H1, I'll take it in one print line. Okay, I can take it here. Then, just a minute. So I'll take it here. I'll take this particular last line. I need one more print line. Okay. So what I do is pw dot print. Okay. So here copy paste it. So here we already know that. Okay. So this is how you can distribute your code on multiple lines. So even you can write it in a single line, you can write it in multiple lines. This is also fine. So now there is some error with the server. So that is okay. You can restart it any number of times. Now here, once you do the changes, what has to be done? You come down to servers and restart it. Every time you make changes to your servlet file, you have to restart. Once you restart, then only you can run the file. Okay. So now it is saying that server has started and synchronized. I hope this is clear, pretty clear. This is an interface IDE, Eclipse Photon I have used. Then API, servlet API jar has to be added, add server has to be added. So I told you how to add the server. Click on server, right click, new, and do that. So these are simple. Once you do this, you can take more number of examples and do it. Okay. So these are some of the references which I have referred. You can go through it. Okay. Thank you.